Hi guys, I am Trisha with Insectopia, here to talk to you about termites and their explosive and self-destructive defensive mechanism. Well, maybe not all termites, but definitely Neocapritermes taracua from Central and South America. Let's back up and introduce you to termites. You see, many people find identifying the differences between an ant and a termite very difficult. I'm here to tell you that the differences are many and the similarities are few. Yes, you can find both in your home, and yes, they both can cause structural problems, but that is where the similarities end. Ant workers are all female, whereas termites have male and female workers. Ant eggs hatch into grubs that must be fed by workers, don't have legs, and have to pupate before becoming an adult ant. Termite eggs hatch into immature termites. They still have to be fed, but they do not require any type of pupa or resting stage before they can molt and go to work. Ants are related to bees and wasps, whereas termites are related to cockroaches. Yes, termites are actually just small communal cockroaches. Physically, an ant is going to have antennae that bend like an elbow, and a termite is going to have antennae that look like a string of beads. All termites start off as little itty-bitty tiny eggs. When termite eggs hatch, the nymphal termites are small, white, and soft. They do not have eyes, and their mouth parts take time to harden. They must be fed by worker termites. The worker termites will feed their young for about 2 weeks. Afterwards, those immatures will molt into workers. This stage in the termite's life is still considered immature, as they do not have developed reproduction organs or eyes. Termites are interesting in that they have the ability to shed their exoskeleton and stay the same size. This is what's called a stationary molt. They will molt their exoskeleton, but they do not grow. Workers spend their time taking care of the young, feeding and cleaning each other and the adults, gathering food, and building and cleaning the home. Keep in mind, many times the enlarged size of the mandibles of soldiers means that they must be fed by a worker. A worker termite can live for a year or more without ever molting into adulthood. The worker also may molt progressively, which means into the next life stage. For a worker termite, there are three options. One, molting into a nymph with wing buds. Two, molting into a pre-soldier nymph. Or three, development into a reproductive replacement over the course of one or two molts, referred to as a neotenic reproductive. If a termite has molted into a nymph with wing buds, it is only one molt away from being an alate. An alate is a fully reproductive adult termite with a hardened body, 4 full-length wings, and compound eyes. These individuals get to fly through the air in large mating swarms and start new colonies. Or, the termite can molt regressively and molt back into an immature without wing buds. This would mean the immature is back to cleaning, feeding, and colonial care. This ability to regressively molt is an incredible feat in the insect world, although I bet the termites don't think so. They get put back on cleaning duty. If the termite starts the process as a pre-soldier nymph, it becomes sterile and will molt once more to gain the characteristics of the soldier for that colony. Different types of termites have different types of soldiers. Some soldiers have large sclerotized heads with mandibles, and some have developed water gun-like projections on their head to spray acid at opponents. These are called nasutes. If the termite molts into a neotenic reproductive replacement, it molts into a mature adult with the ability to molt, although they will not mate unless the current reproductive is dead or dying. They spend most of their time in the natal nest and will mate to save the colony from collapse in case of emergency. Yet, most termites stay immature workers their entire lives. This takes a toll on their bodies as they spend much time chewing on wood and other hard substances that wear down their mandibles. At some point over the course of this process, our friend, the Neocapritermes taracua, will start to develop a little blue crystal in a pocket on their exoskeleton, right here between the thorax and the abdomen. This crystal develops as the termite ages. Researchers in the Czech Republic have found that as the feeding efficiency for workers decreases, they build up their crystals for this self-destructive attack method. In the event of an attack on the colony, the oldest workers will use this little copper-containing crystal. When the crystal comes into contact with saliva from a gland under the exoskeleton, it causes a chemical reaction that explodes out of the termite's body, which kills not only the worker, but also the intruder. I have to admit, the life of a termite doesn't seem easy. I almost feel bad for the little workers. Let's check out some termites. Thank you for listening. Our buggy question is, have you ever seen a soldier termite? Share your stories below. Make sure to like and subscribe for more videos like this one. Come back soon to check out our next epic insect tale.